Tom, you explained during your keynote speaker sessions about five key problems that IT has and how they imagine IT would solve it in a different way. I'd like you to further explain these key problems and what you propose to them.
Sure, sure. Well, thank you for that question. I think it's an interesting time in IT, right? I think the business is expecting IT to be faster and to be more agile and to be efficient. And there are five particular things that I think the business is expecting of IT, which is creating good opportunities and interesting challenges for IT. The first of those is to make sure that IT can enable a mobile workforce. We want the people that are talking to our customers that are outside of the office to have all the information at their fingertips available to them all the time. And we want to make sure that they are as productive with their phones as they might be sitting behind a desk in the office, because we want to maximize the amount of time that people are spending in front of customers and spending in the field. So the mobility agenda is a big agenda for the business side, and it is asking IT to figure out a way to enable and make productive the mobile workforce. The second problem that we talked about was the traditional applications that we've built and that we run in IT are very large applications that have been built to automate key business processes. I think of ERP systems or customer relationship management systems, maybe some of the applications in our mainframes. They are here to make a business process more efficient. And I think that IT has done a very nice job of doing that over the past 25 years. But when I look forward, I think what the business wants is a new app to be developed very quickly for a customer opportunity that may only be around for a month or two. Maybe we're learning that a new customer trend is taking off, and we want to find a way to capitalize on that quickly. So we need to develop an application very fast that allows us to take advantage of that short-term opportunity. Getting to the point where we're developing applications much more quickly, doing that in an agile way, is really the future, and the business is asking IT to step up to that challenge. The third challenge is that we are swimming in information, but sometimes bringing all that information together and drawing some conclusions and some insights from that is more difficult than it should be. We have many different analysts coming together to take different sources of information and bring them together into one large spreadsheet. Wouldn't it be easier if we had a real system, a real data lake that understood all of the different information in the enterprise and we could draw conclusions over that? The fourth trend is around the data center. We've done a great job in the past 25 years building robust, strong data centers that manage and keep our applications available. But those applications are very tightly coupled to infrastructure today. And so what we would like to do is get to the point where we're much more agile, we're much quicker. The application can find whatever infrastructure is needed without having to be tightly connected to any one infrastructure stack. So a software-defined data center is really the fourth challenge that the business has. And the fifth one relates to security. We are protecting those data centers historically with intrusion protection and vulnerability assessments and scanning capabilities. We spend two-thirds of our IT security budgets on preventing people from getting at our information. But they get at it anyway, because the people that are looking for information are as technologically savvy as our IT departments are. So rather than spend time preventing them from coming in, we need to acknowledge that they are likely to be inside our data centers. We should be monitoring their activities, and we should be making sure that when they get close to some sensitive information, that we can intervene just in time, proactively, and stop them from doing something that could be truly damaging to the company. So, mobility, agile application development, data lakes, big data architectures, a software-defined data center, and proactive security. Those are, I think, five trends that the business is saying to IT, please help make this happen. We need this in the company today.
And how are them combined with mobile, cloud computing, big data, and social media that are buzzwords that we hear all the time?
Yes. Well, so some of them are direct correlations, right? So when we say mobile, cloud, big data, and social, the agenda around enabling mobility is the same as the mobile trends, right? So when I say to you that that the business is learning that it can be much more productive in its personal life with the mobile devices that an executive has in his personal life than perhaps he can be in the office, business people are taking their experiences from their personal life and saying, why can't I have that same mobility in everything that I do in the enterprise? So that's a direct correlation. Also, the big data conversation and our concept of data lakes. is a very direct conversation, right? We want to bring different sources of information together. We want to analyze that information as if it was one large database, and we want to make real-time insights so that we can predict some behavior rather than react to something that happened historically. And when we say cloud, to us, the software-defined data center is really the next evolution of cloud, getting to public and private and hybrid data center architectures that are heavily automated, services-oriented, and in that sense, cloud-like. Those are direct correlations as well. The one that's a little bit more subtle is the social media side, right? And I think that's, if you're in marketing today in an enterprise, you care a lot about what is going on in social media, right? What people are saying about your company and your brand is hugely important. But I think that is going beyond marketing. I think salespeople are starting to get concerned. What is my customer saying about me? And I think engineering organizations are starting to say, what is my product mean to this customer? So the social part is getting embedded into the idea that we need to be faster and more agile in our data centers, in our data architectures, in our applications, and in the end user computing. So it's a little bit of a less direct connection, but it gets to how fast we need to respond in this world going forward.
Changing a little bit the subjects to the federation model that IMSC is talking about, I'd like you to discuss about what kind of challenges this model brings, because it's a little bit different from what we see from your competitors, for example, or other companies' models.
Yep. Well, let me first remind you of the advantages, because there are many advantages to this model, right? I think it allows us to innovate in all of the different parts of the UC Federation, right? So VMware can design a software-defined data center suite that is independent of infrastructure and independent of the application platform. So if EMC storage is the best storage for a certain customer, that's great. It should fit very nicely with VMware. But if a customer has made a big investment in IBM or HP or some other storage, they can still invest in VMware without having to write off an investment that they've already made in another part of the stack. So I think it gives the customer big choices, and those choices are very important to customers. When I spend time with customers, they love the strategy of saying, you will create the best of breed products at every part of the stack, and let me make decisions about which technologies I want to use. And if I have made a historical investment in your competitor, you're not forcing me to get rid of the investment that I've already made. I can protect that investment and still work with the UC Federation. That's very much a part of the strategy. You know, the complexities in that model are sometimes we want to make sure that we're bringing the best of the Federation together. And the VMware account team will have a conversation wants to have with the client, and the EMC account team will want to have a related but perhaps separate conversation. And as a federation of companies, the customer expects us to behave as one. So we have to do some coordination between our various parts of the federation so that we're bringing one clear message to the customer. I would say to you that that's not so different from some of our large competitors. Large competitors who have multiple divisions, they also have different sales forces in these different divisions, and they also have the same conversation that they need to have so that they can create one face to the customer. So it is something that EMC has to learn how to do. It is something customers are expecting us to do as a federation, but it's not something that's very different from what our competitors are facing as well.